On this episode of Crappie Kings Television, back in Sweet Home, Alabama, on Pickwick Lake, with my good buddy, Brad Whitehead, side pulling for crappie.
Side pulling, it was actually designed here on Pickwick. It was designed by a guy named Roger Gant.
Fish. Adam White. What is side pulling? Like, I mean, Brad's got the trolling motor mounted on the side of the boat. Can you believe that?
There he is, Carl.
Not that time. Keep that bend there. Look at that. Did he choke it? Choked it.
From Canada, wanting to come to Pickwick, Alabama, to crappie fish in June. Hey, we
good
got
slab.
It. We got it. That's ours right there, buddy.
Deadly wave. Catch crappie in June.
Get it.
There he is. Into the net. Oh, look at that. No net, no fish. I'm Carl Kalanka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way. Visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. Pickwick Lake, here we come. Gonna catch some slabs.
I got a phone call from Carl from Canada wanting to come to Pickwick, Alabama to crappie fish in June.
Side pulling. What is side pulling? Like, I mean, Brad's got the trolling motor mounted on the side of the boat. Now that's a first for me.
Side pulling, it was actually designed here on Pickwick. It was designed by a guy named Roger Gant. And, you know, I was real skeptical of it for several years because I run glass boats and spider rig when I started guiding. And, you know, I figure if a man that's in his 60s, like Roger, that guides 280 days a year, this ought to be good for me. And it's really nice, you know, you can set a seat there in the middle. And everybody's fishing fresh water. And that's what you're gonna see today. You're gonna see us cover a lot of water and catch the most active fish.
It's the little things that make a big difference. The position of the rod holders. You know, there've been a lot of guys' boats. And these guys are intense as it gets. You think the Bass Pros are intense? I'm telling you, the crappie guys are just as intense because that's what they fish for. So they gotta have the tools, the equipment, where they want it, so it's comfortable, especially for a guy like Brad who's guiding. Customers have to be happy, they got to catch fish, but they have to enjoy their day. But he's got to have everything he needs in those positions, so when he needs it, he knows where it is, and he just gets it and he catch fish.
You get the right boat, right package together, it absolutely works perfectly.
I'm impressed. He's got all the right setup. You know what, when I get a guy's boat, I look to see how everything's set up, you know, if the guy really knows what he's doing. And Brad does. Little small things like having the pliers accessible. Now to me, that shows me this guy knows what he's doing.
This is a design that keeps your trolling motor locked in place. You can travel with it up and down the road. You unscrew a knob, it turns, it sits really, really nice right on the side. You know, again, this technique looks crazy with the trolling motor on the side. You know, you just don't, you don't see that every day. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna flip the boat around. We're going to kind of get lined up on a couple of these. There's several underwater ditches that that we fish out here. Turn around, get everything lined up. You know, yesterday it was cloudy, windy, and the fish were on the move. And I was really worried when we got here this morning that conditions had changed so much. Sunny, a little bit of clouds, I was worried. All right, here's what we're going to do today. It's fairly simple. Technique, we're going to be fishing with two different kind of baits. We're going to be fishing with a hair jig. They're 2/4 ounce hair jigs. I like something heavy. I want to move fast. I want to move a lot, have a, you know, cover a lot of water. And you've got to have a lot of weight to cover a lot of water. And it's really neat what we're going to do. These jigs are 2 foot apart. What we're going to do, we're going to lay the top jig in the water, and these B&M poles that we have, they're called the Difference, and they're designed for this style of fishing, side pulling. It's an 8-2 rod. It's 8 feet long. It's a two-piece rod. And if you notice, it's got three little flags here. And we're going to consider that a pull. And what I mean by a pull is we know our fish. We're sitting in 21 to 22 foot of water. We know our fish are anywhere from 2 to 4 foot off the bottom. All right. What we're going to do is literally count down to them and keep our jigs in a strike zone at all times. What we're going to do, we're going to pull off 20 pulls, but we're going to start with three. And why we start with three is because we've already got 2 foot in the water. We try to make this as precise as we can. What we're going to do, we're going to pull off. We're going to go 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. We're fishing. We'll click the rod over, lay it in the rod holder, and we're ready to go. Now here in Alabama, we can use multiple rods. There's only two lakes in Alabama that you've got a pole limit. So I think the more rods, the more baits, the more fish we can catch. And that seems to work very well for us. So we're gonna get a few more of these rigged up, get Karl rigged up, and try to put some fish in the boat.
Anytime I can get out with a guy like Brad that knows what he's doing and just change it up, different presentations, different times of the year, techniques, baits, you name it, these guys impress the heck out of me. My lucky pull of the day, 1, 2, 3. I'm saying that one.
Which one?
This one.
I'm gonna say the outside.
Are you?
Fish.
Right there. You feel any good? Oh, he come off?
Ha!
That's the jinx of the first bite of the day, isn't it? He had some pull to it, didn't he? Your rod had some mark in it.
That's great, boy. Boy, that makes you feel like a winner. That was a good fish, too.
I'm glad that wasn't my fish. If I lost the first one with a bend in the rod like that, I'd be disappointed. I'm glad that wasn't me.
I wanted to impress Karl, because I knew him coming down to Pickwick here, we had to catch some big fish. I wanted him to see some really nice fish from Pickwick. The first strike, I set the hook, make two turns, the fish comes off. I wasn't happy. All right, Karl. Make a net, buddy.
He feels just like a... good slab.
Hey,
good slab.
It. We got him. That's ours right there, buddy. How about that right there?
Well, that's a nice little fish, isn't he?
Look at here.
Yes.
Pretty
picture fish.
Pretty fish.
Look at that. Did he choke it? Choked it. That's why you gotta have them pliers. Into the box.
Uh-oh, right here under it.
Right here?
Beautiful fish.
Your side or my side doesn't
matter? It don't
matter,
just push it.
Okay. First one in the box, but it won't be the last one. Brad had some that were bending out down. We're bending real good too. We're gonna get them.
I got you loaded back up.
Perfect. Thank you.
One more in your clip there.
And we're ready to go again. Some of these bites have actually buried the rod. Boom! We'll lose them right at 5 feet in front of the boat. And the other ones choke it.
Ha! All right, Karl.
Netter?
Nah, we're on.
Oh, nice fish. Ho ho ho! Look at the mouth on that. Oh, buddy, nice crappie.
Whoo, didn't let me down. I was a little nervous with that one. A little nervous.
In the meat, you need the pliers?
I got it.
Beautiful fish, and you called it. You said, get ready. I was ready, but it was on that rod. As long as in the boat, doesn't matter, Brad.
That's right.
Nice fish, too.
Thank you.
Wow. No daydreaming, eh, Brad?
No, you've got to really stay on with these rods, especially on days like today where we're getting these short strikes. If you're looking off, daydreaming, looking at birds or looking at boats go by, you're busted. Oh, we got that one. We got it. That's a nice fish.
It's a crappie.
Nice eater.
Look at that.
Nice
he ate a bit
eater.
Better too, didn't he? Look at that.
Nice eater.
Up in the top yap. Look where he ate that. Even if I was sleeping, I probably would have got that fish. You know, there are two things, either big or they eat it good. That's a decent eater?
That's a decent eater there.
Okay, he's going in the box. Look at the sides on him. Nice chunky fillets there. Those are the ones you want to take home to eat, eh? Beautiful. Love Pickwick into the box. Missed the last one like that? That one ate it.
Fish.
Adam, what? Feel good?
Good fish, Carl.
Want to grab that net?
I think I can get him in.
Oh, is it? Oh, you can do it? Oh, nice fish, buddy. Nice fish.
Oh, he sunk that jig. That's what we're looking for. That's what we're looking for, my friend.
Oh, he's got some length, too. That's a nice crappie.
He hit it like he meant business.
Beautiful fish, man. Look at the hump on his back. Good stuff, buddy.
That's what we're after. Pickwick Lake, Alabama.
In June. In the box, huh?
I think we're going to take him with us.
Yes.
Hey, after putting three or four fish in the live well, I knew we were going to get a pattern. We had dialed in. Carl had the hook set just right, and things were going to look better.
It's June. I'm in my shorts, t-shirt, catching crappie. Pickwick in June for crappie. It is accessible, because you can do it with a guy like Brad.
Carl, when things get slow, there's only one thing I know to do. Go to the go-to bait. Tie on a few of these road runners and see if we can get these fish shook out of these treetops.
Sounds good. That little blade just could entice a couple bigger bites, you know that?
It could.
Road runner, the crappie's after you. Road runner, when he catches you, you're through. Meep, meep.
Man, that's good.
Hey?
Rot rod. Ooh, good fish, Carl.
He's right below the boat, too.
Need the net?
Oh, you come off. You talk about light bite. You know, you can just tell sometimes. The hook's real close to the edge of the mouth and stuff like that. And you watch the rods, and it's going boing right down. You think, got a fish. You have him halfway to the boat, boom, come slack. There ain't no worse feeling in the world for a fisherman than that rod going slack. You just bumped it. Real sharp and fast. Not that time. Oh, you mama. Wow. Whew. Can't catch them all. You believe that?
There he is, Carl.
Not that time. Keep that bend there. And you don't feel too bad, do you?
Hey, that's all right.
Oh, he got on another line,
that's
too.
That's all right. Look at there.
Eater size.
That is.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, man. Pickwick at its finest.
You know, this time of year, the fish are post-spawn, so you're really not looking to catch a whole lot of nice fish. But after these, I thought, hey, we have really got some nice ones.
Netter?
I think I can get him in.
Oh, good fish. See, I'm going through the little guys.
There you go.
Nice
one, Brad. I told you, I can't take it.
That's right.
I can let you catch a few, but.
Yep. Filter out the babies. Good crappie.
I have
crappie.
Got good to crappie. Catch one.
Oh, look at the mouth on
beautiful.
That.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful fish.
That's a dinner guest, isn't it?
That is dinner.
Dinner guest. Mm-hmm. Like, seriously, how can you beat this? Look at it out. Look at this, man. It's like paradise. It's June, and we're catching crappie. 20 feet of water. Man, oh, man. This technique, you gotta consider to try.
Good fish, Carl. You are getting me today,
light bite.
Boy. I mean, getting to me.
I think he's on the other one, too. Oh, see on this one?
There you go.
He's on this one. Mere crappie. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. You can't even see the jig, Brad.
That's what we've been looking for.
I'd say. Oh, boy. Crappie, you wanted to be a dinner guest of the Whiteheads, and now you are going to be a dinner guest, Brad and his family, because you know why? Just perfect size. Look at, nice back on them. I don't know if it's a male or female, but they've done all their stuff they're supposed to do, making more babies, but now They're gonna help us by feeding us so we can come out and fish again. Love it. Just perfect size, isn't it?
It is.
Although as fishermen, we always want the big ones, don't we?
It's nice to have a few in the live well, though, that are just good eaters.
Yes, sir. No complaint from me.
There's no second guessing it. When they hit that thing and there's slack in that line, they mean business. And that is the best. 99.9% of the time, when they hit it like that, it's a good fish and you're gonna get it in because it's gonna be in the back of his throat.
We're back and headed over to O'Brien's Family Steakhouse in downtown Tuscumbia, Alabama for some good old-fashioned Southern hospitality and good eats.
Today I'm going to be preparing Derby chicken, which is one of our specialties we had put on the menu. It's a 6-ounce grilled chicken breast. It's marinated with barbecue sauce on our broiler. We actually put 2 slices of hickory smoked bacon on there, and then we melt Swiss cheese over the top of it. Plate it out with a pickle and barbecue sauce, a piece of Texas toast, and a side of your choice. Now let's go in the kitchen and I'll show you how to make a Derby chicken. Well, basically we start with a 6-ounce raw chicken breast and bring it over to the broiler, put it on. We allow that to kind of cook for just a little bit. We put a little seasoned salt on it. And it cooks for just about, takes about 11 minutes start to finish on it. But we let it get started on one side. Then what we do is we'll take our tongs and kind of move it around a little bit, cook it real well on both sides, make sure that it's got enough cooking and sear on it. And then we'll start the Derby process. Once it gets cooked pretty well, we do bacon on the flat grill. It's a hickory smoked bacon. And then we take barbecue sauce and we marinate the chicken breast really well with the barbecue sauce. And it's just a sweet sauce. Let both sides cook just a little. And we get our bacon. 2 slices of the hickory bacon. Put those on. And then we get the cheese and put on it. And you can see the bacon starting to sizzle, and the edges of the chicken will sizzle, and the Swiss melts down around it. And once it gets nice and melted, we take our spatula and pull it off. Every chicken comes with a pickle and barbecue sauce. We put a piece of toast on the plate. Then we take that sweet, open it up, and set it in the window, and that's our Derby chicken.
Wow, talk about impressive. I can't wait to dive into this famous O'Brien's Derby chicken. Now let's get back on the water.
I told Carl, hey, with the sun getting up, we probably need to go to a little bit deeper water. So we made a move, and this is what happened.
Oh. Wow.
Get him, boy. Get him. Get him.
There we go. There he is. At that time.
I don't know if that's a crappie or not. Oh yeah, nice, nice.
How many times did he eat that?
Twice.
Boy, oh boy. He gave me a chance and then another chance, huh? Good eater too, isn't it?
Good job. Perfect.
Thanks, Brad.
Absolutely perfect. Beautiful fish,
Carl. Beautiful fish, man. Gonna go in a skillet, isn't he?
Krappie Alabama crappie.
Thank you, sir. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21.
Yes, sir.
We're almost done for the day, people. And I'm telling you, another fun day catching them, not just in spring, but summertime too. And you're going to see fall, winter, you name it. Whatever it takes, whatever presentation, anywhere in North America where there's crappie, we're going to go. Because we want to show you that they can be caught with different presentations, different baits, and different techniques, just like we're doing now. Almost finished. That sun's going to get up real high. We've got some nice fish in the live well. That's all we need, man. Don't need to just sink the boat with fish. That's not the deal here. It's fun to come out and catch them. And we are
oh,
right there.
Carl, you're killing me. You're killing me, Carl.
Oh, that's money. Look at that. Oh! What a fish, son.
Look at
you
that crappie.
You're killing me today.
Crappie. Look at that, man. Wow.
That is nice.
Look at that thing.
June crappie fish.
Yeah, man. Brad, you're the man. Honest to God. You put it all together the same way you would for a customer.
Well, I have thoroughly enjoyed fishing with you, Carl.
Yeah, man. Man, I love this. I'm telling you, you never know what to expect. You know what? You never know, no matter who it is. The conditions change, the fish move, whatever it is. Maybe they don't want to bite, but today I was very, very impressed. Brad said, we're going to catch some fish. We're going to have some fun, but keep in the back of your mind, it's June, so it's not going to be wildfire, but we're going to catch some fish. That's all I was asking for, to catch some fish. And I'm telling you, I'm more than pleased. Had a great time.
The water temperature is nearly 80 degrees. And with all the odds stacked against us, we really got a nice batch of fish. I was happy. I felt like Carl was really happy with this catch. And that goes to show you, you can still catch summertime crappie.
And a big thank you to the Coldwater Inn for providing accommodations to the staff of Crappie Kings Television. Crappie Kings Television, in association with Art Rule the Water. B&M Poles, wherever fishing takes you. Roadrunner Fishing Lures. Visit us at crappiekings.com.